Valley, watch our men play tonight, but this is a good win for us. As I found out earlier, I was in college the last time the Aggies won, so that was a long time ago, I'll tell you that. Any win right now is a good win for us because we can't explain why we're 1-6 coming into this game. Just can't explain it. Expectations are a lot higher. I feel like we're a better team than our record shows, but we're making progress this last week, and we have a team that is low baggage, high chemistry, and so that's what we're building on. And tonight's game should go a long ways because it is a rivalry game for us. And this will go a long ways.
How big is it to come into the Marriott Center and build a big lead like you guys did to be able to go up by 10 at the half?
We needed every point, that's for sure. We had a 20-point lead, if I remember right. Was that in the fourth quarter or third quarter? I can't remember. That's kind of our Achilles heel right now. We've three or four of our losses, we've had good third, fourth quarter leads, and we've lost them. And tonight, you know, we kind of showed kind of where our Achilles heel is, and but it's very objective. I know we can get better at that part of the game, but direct answer your question, it's a big win. Road wins are big, but probably a road win at BYU is just like a road win for us, maybe at Boise State or Colorado State, who are our rivals in conference.
You guys won a long time toward the end of the fourth quarter without making a shot, then Rachel really stepped up big with two big shots. Is that kind of what you expected?
Yeah, you know, Rachel's on the floor that time with three sophomores and maybe a freshman. She's a junior. She's proven over and over again this year, her junior year, that she's really our leader when it kind of the blood and guts part of the game, you know, trying to get things done. She had a couple of big rebounds. Rachel's fun to coach, and she wants to win. And I feel probably most comfortable with calm plays for Rachel, you know, down the stretch. And that run where we weren't making shots, we weren't running plays. And I was frustrated with some of our younger guards made some really poor decisions, got caught up in the game. But Rachel hit that big shot. That was calming for us, definitely.
Rachel, can you just talk about those final minutes? BYU's just whittling away that lead and stepping up to make those shots. What was kind of the mentality?
It was a little bit scary, yeah. But I've been in a lot of situations in my career where we've been in that sort of situation. So, I just have to stay focused. And I had open shots, so, like, it's my job to make them. So you just kind of treat it as a normal shot in the game. You don't really think about the situation and if we're down or up or losing a lead and all that kind of thing. So you just have to stay focused and make the shots.
It was a lot of nerves on our coaches, I know, because the BYU girls, we have a lot of respect for the three guards statistically. Those three guards can shoot the ball and do a lot of things with it. And that's how they came back in. They hit some big shots, had a guard off the bench, shot some threes. I thought we did a really good job for 2.5 quarters guarding them. And then they started, you know, percentages started catching up. And that's when they closed the gap. They're definitely a guard-strong lineup right now. When they get the Hammonds girl back in the lineup, that'll give them more balance for sure for their game plan.
It seemed when you were building the lead that you were taking really good shots, just knowing you had a lot of shots under the basket and all that. How's the offense so efficient starting out?
Just we've really emphasized, like, our first few games. We think one of the reasons why we're 1-6 is – 2-6 now, is we just weren't getting ball movement. So we really emphasized driving to the basket, kicking out, and perimeter movement just to get open shots, and it's working for us. So we just make sure that we keep doing that in our games.
Yeah, kind of, I think our fans at home, you know, whoever's listening or reading this, is that I think we turned a little bit of a corner this past weekend in Maui against Oregon State, who's a top 20 team and extremely strong team. But the second half, we really held our own, and I think we gained some confidence in our game plan and gained confidence in each other. And I think knocking on wood here, they're knocking on the door that I think we turned a corner. And I think we're going to begin making some progress now towards that win-loss column too because of it.
Hey, Rachel, do you feel like things just kind of started coming together, I guess, this game a little bit? Because it didn't look like you guys were doing anything too crazy. It was just
executing and following the game plan, which is something we haven't been doing lately. And like Coach said, the Oregon State game was kind of like a turning the corner for us. Despite the score, I think it was the best game that we've played so far, and it was just a lot of fun to play in that game. So we know what we need to do now, and we're just